Now, I was thinking one day about greatness. And this was a few years ago as I was building my company. And I realized that greatness is often achieved in the face of adversity. You know, what would Superman be without Lex Luthor? You have great sports rivalries and political rivalries. Well, in our company, we had got out of the chute so quickly. And a few years in, we were the dominant player in our field. And we were so far ahead of the competitive set that we didn't have a big evil enemy to go after. So here's what I did. I invented one. So I rolled out to our company our fictitious nemesis, our made-up bad guys, the Slither Corporation. And I announced to our team, and this wasn't, by the way, to make us feel better. It was to challenge us. So I said, folks, there's a company out there that's bigger than us, and they're faster than us, and they're more profitable than us, and they're more innovative than we are. Slither. And this went on to become part of our culture because we made up the imaginary ultimate competitor. And we would do fun things. We would intercept memos, our spies inside Slither, and find out what they're doing. We'd get Wall Street Journal clippings of their earnings report. And we had a lot of fun with it. But I'll tell you what it did is it challenged us to go that extra step in our creative thinking. We mentioned earlier that fear is such a huge blocker of creativity and often can get in the way of us executing great ideas. So what we did at our company is we asked the question differently. I'll give you an example. If I said, all right, how can we shave 2 days out of our cycle time? People would clam up because they don't want to offend the person who put that process in place at first. So we stopped asking the question that way. Here's what we would say. Our spies just got an internal report, and we heard that Slither shaved 2 days out of their cycle time. How do you think they did it? Well, what happened was that the whiteboards became filled with ideas. Because there was no personal threat, it was a third party, so people could really express themselves. Now, I know most of us have real competitors, but I'd like to challenge you to think about something. What if someone down the block from you opened up a brand new company, and you had a crystal ball, and you realized that 5 years from now, they would be eating your lunch. Whether you represent a big brand or a small company, they would be putting you out of business. What would they do differently? How would they approach their work if they had a blank sheet? I'll tell you, someday a company, no matter how big you are, someday a company is going to come along and put you out of business. It might as well be you.